All right, this morning, joined by Brett Schatto, our Group CEO from Adelaide. Brett, great to have you along. Now, we're talking Centrelink today. Now, the first thing is, many people don't realise they're eligible for age pension or benefits associated with the age pension. You know, roughly what is the proportion of Australians who might be eligible at least for some benefits through Centrelink?
There's been a few studies, and look, up to 70% of people that are retired are eligible,
yep.
But not necessarily 70% are actually on something.
Yeah.
And part of our job is to improve the entitlements and the eligibility in the first place.
If you were to nominate something that was a big shift for a lot of people in terms of their eligibility for the age pension, a single strategy, what would it be? What should they do?
Potentially making contributions into the younger person's name in superannuation. Anything that's in superannuation under age pension age is not assessed as an asset. So if the older person in the relationship gets to age pension age and there's an assets test problem because whatever they have in their superannuation is assessed, then there is the potential within the limits to be able to cash out that money and re-contribute it into the younger person's name.
Yeah.
On the basis that you're happy with first-time marriages and that estate planning type stuff, absolutely. Also, spending money. It's not spend it so that you're just living off the age pension, but prepaying holidays. People generally want to retire and go on that trip that they've put off for the last 30 years. Prepaying that 12 months in advance, taking advantage of specials and having that money disappear out of the bank account and letting Centrelink know of that money gone, it improves eligibility.
Yeah, quite a few asterisks on it, but the bottom line is you can increase someone's eligibility for some age pension. Yeah, one that many people are eligible for, in fact, I think majority of Australians really are eligible for, is a seniors health card. Now, what sort of benefits does a seniors health card give someone?
Look, certainly cheap pharmaceuticals, and as we get older, we need prescription medication more and more. So we find that now anywhere between, say, $3,000 and $5,000 a year could be the upside of having one of those cards. So one of the reasons people in the past have wanted to be eligible for a dollar a fortnight of Centrelink is because of the pensioner concession card that comes with that.
Yep.
For people that have just over the assessments for either asset or income and don't qualify, they then chase the Commonwealth Seniors Health Card for those benefits. So it's not quite the same as the pensioner concession card, but there are definitely some benefits in being able to apply and receive it.
Now, Brett, a big thing, a big focus of your business in Adelaide is helping people make application and then continue to liaise with Centrelink. That can be a fairly onerous task for a lot of people, can't it?
Look, it can. When people come in to see us for the first time, they say, goodness, I went down to the local Centrelink office and spent 3 hours lined up and I didn't have all the paperwork with me. Had to leave and then come back, and you know it's just quite off-putting. So perhaps some of the reason people don't receive their part age pension is because they just don't want to have to deal with an increasing lineup at the Centrelink office or getting put on hold for 25-30 minutes when they make a phone call.
Definitely. So lots of strategies. We're going to unpack these strategies over the next couple of weeks.
Excellent.
So watch out for these videos as they update, folks. But Brett, that's a good introduction to the age pension and some of the eligibility factors. Thanks for your time, mate.
Thank you.